Okay, here we will continue with the next module that is about the array, right? In this class, in this course, right, we are going to use data structure and appropriate data structure for a specific problem, right? And I think array is the most important. The most important construct that can be, you can use in C, right, as an array, as a data structure, right, as you can see from the lab yesterday, right. Oops, what happened to all that? So this the I don't know why this. Is disappear. Okay, no problem. So, okay. First of all, I would like to introduce you again about array, right? Array is actually a collection or a set of similar data elements that's stored in the main memory in as a consecutive memory location, right? So, in this way, when you define an array, right, it has to be the same data, the same set of the data, and it has to be stored in the consecutive memory location, right? So sometimes if you want to reference each element in array, you have to use index. Sometimes we can say that it is a subscript, and the subscript is an ordinal number which is used to identify an array, an element of an array. For this example, if you want to define 20 variables for 20 students, right? The score for the 20 students, you can refer to, if you don't have array, you have to name it as mark 1, mark 2, mark 3, mark 4, mark 5, 6, 7, and so on, right? This is in C programming. Is this case is possible, but it's not efficient. So you may have to define that in term, define it into the array, right? So when you declare an array, right? You can, in C programming, you can use, okay, you have start from the type, the data type of this array. In this case, integer is a data type and marks is the name of this array of 10 integer. The number 10 here is referred to the number of elements in this array. So this will allocate in memory the contiguous memory, right? Element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until 10. But if you want to refer to access to the first element, you have to write like marks subscript 0, and the second one will be mark subscript 1, and so on, right? So this is the way that C programming will allow you to access or to declare an array. I think I post the slide in LEB2. Okay, maybe I will. I will post slide here in. Okay, I post slide to in your like group. Okay, this is the way that we declare an array. And the next, okay, this is some examples of how to declare arrays, right? If you want to declare a string, right? String is an array of character, right? You have to declare like this. Car, right, is a character. The name is an array of character, right, of 15 characters, right? So you, when you want to access to this string, right, sometimes we call array of character as a string, right? So we have 15 elements starting from the index 0. And for the floating point salary 5, right, we have the array size of 5 floating points number, right? So here we have 5 floating points and accessed by the subscript 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, the next slide will be about how to access the elements of array, right? Array are declared using the foreign syntax, right? If you declare integer marks 10 elements of integer, and then if you want to assign minus one value to each element of marks, right, you can use for loop from I from 0 to 10, I plus plus and then marks I is equal to minus one. So every elements in this array will be assigned that or will be initialized to minus one. Okay, this is a way to access to the element of the array. But once when you want to use the array, the most important things that you might have to know that is how to calculate the address of array. Because you have known that in C programming, you can access or you can know the address, the physical address of the memory, right? So an array is a kind of the pointer, right? So in order to access to a specific address of an array, you may have to know how to calculate, right? In order to access the data of the element AK at subscript K, right? You have to start from base address A plus W multiplied it by K minus lower bound, where A is an array and K is the index of element index K, right? We have to calculate for the address of AK, right? And W is the size of the element, one element in memory. For example, if you are going to define array of integer has a size 4 bytes, right? So W will be 4, right? For example, size of integer of is 2, okay? So this is an example of how to calculate the base address or the address of the variable marks subscript 4, right? So in this case, right, the base address is 100, right? And for each element of this is an integer. So integer requires 2 bytes. So W is 2. And then you want to go to the address of marks 4. So you put 4 here. And then the base address is minus 0. The lower bound is 0, so you can use minus 0 here or not, and then you multiply 4 by 2, and then you can get the address of marks 4, which is 108. Okay, this is the way to calculate for the address of array element. Do you have any question? Okay, it's pretty easy, right, for the how to calculate the address of the array element, right? If you know the base address, if you know the size of an element, and if you want to know the address of an array at a particular subscript, so you can just simply use this equation. If you want to calculate for the length of an array, right, you can use this equation, upper bound minus lower bound plus one, right? For this example, if you want to, okay, if you have array of eight for 5 elements of integers, right? Like this, right? If you want to calculate for the length of an array, is lower bound always 0? I guess so. Lower bound always 0 because we always start from from zero, from the base address. Mm-hmm. Normally, when we talk about the base address, we will talk about the an array. We will start from the base address, subscript zero. Mm-hmm. I'm quite surprised about this equation as well, because normally I will not use the lower bound. Okay, when I want to calculate for the address, right, I just use the base address plus WK. Okay, W means the size of the element and K is a subscript. Thank you for your question. Right, this is the direct message to me. Okay. And if you want to calculate for the length of an array, right, how many lengths, so you have to know the lower bound and upper bound, right? Upper bound is 4, lower bound is 0, right? And then the formula will be upper bound minus lower bound plus 1. So you can have 4 minus 0 and plus 1. So you can get 5. And we have 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements in this array. Okay, that's correct. Okay, this is a way to calculate for the size of the array. Okay, when we declare an array, we just want to allocate space for each element. Sometimes no value are stored in the array. So there are three ways to store value or initialize value in an array. Okay, the first one is initialize array during declaration. Once you declare, normally when you declare an array, right? For example, for this example, we are going to define 5 elements for marks of integer, right? For the name marks, right? You can initialize by like this. Okay, in the previous lab, right? You need to initialize array of points, right? You have familiar with this already, right? This is the way that you have to initialize an array right away. You declare this array. Okay, this is the one. This is the way. Okay, if you have 5 elements and then you initialize it 5 elements, so every slot will be full of initialization. But if you initialize only 2 out of 5, you will get 90, 45, and 3 zeros. What if you don't even define for the number of elements for this one, right? You can also define like this, right? Marks and brackets without the number of the length of the array. So, and then you put 6 elements here, so it will, for this declaration, it will assume that this 6 will be allocated. 6 elements of integers will be allocated. And then 90 to 54 will be initialized. And if you define like this, right, go to 0 like this. Every slot will be initialized into all zeros. So this is the different way of array initialization. The next method to assign the value to the array is inputting value from keyboard, right? If you define, once again, integer marks 10, right? And you use for loop for 0 to 10, right? You can scan, you scan F percent sign D, and then you use ampersand marks and I, right? This way you have to point the address of each element of the array, right? And then you use scan F in order to get the input from the keyboard and put that value assigned to marks subscript I. This is a way that we input value and then press a value into the corresponding location for the array. The next one is the way that assigning values to individual elements. For example, for the first example, you can see that we have array 1 an array two, there are 10 elements of integer, and then array one has been initialized by this initialized value. And then if you want to assign value to individual elements, right, you can use the for loop, right? And then assign array one I to array two I, right? This is a way to copy an array at individual element level. Or if you want to calculate, right, something from the original array, right, fill an array with even numbers, right? So you can just simply use, okay, I from 0 to 10, right? And array I is equal to I multiplied by 2, right? So you can fill in this array with even numbers. Okay, these are two examples of how to assign value to individual elements in array. So the next topic that I'm going to talk about will be the operations on array, right? When you have an array, right, you need to perform something onto array, right? There are numbers of operations, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 operations for arrays. Today we will talk about traversing, inserting, deleting, and merging. For searching and sorting, I will talk about it in later on, in chapter 14 or something. Okay, but today I will talk about what does it mean by traversing, how to insert, delete an array, element in array, and merge two arrays. Okay, we will start from the first one, that is array traversing. What does it mean traversing? Traverse means travel, right? Travel along array, right? Along an array, right? Traversing the data elements of an array A can include printing every element, counting the number of elements, or performing any process on this element. So because we have known in advance that array is a linear data structure, linear means you have to access from one to another, right? That is the linear manner, right? Because all elements form a sequence. So traversing its element is very simple and straightforward. So I will give you an idea of how to traverse along the array, right? This is an algorithm. This example is an algorithm of array traversal. First of all, step one, right? You have to initialize an array, right? Set I to the lower bound, which is a lower bound subscript of an array. And then repeat step 3 and 2, 4, y, I is less than or equal to upper bound. Now I is set to lower bound, right? But just in case that I is still less than upper bound, so loop step 3 and 4 will be repeated, okay? And then apply process to AI. And set I is equal to I plus one. So increment the number of I until I is equal to upper bound. That would be the last loop that will be executed and then end of loop and then exit from this program. This is an array of array traversal. If you want to convert from this to C program, right? You can see from this example. Suppose I ask you to write a program to read and display n numbers using an array, right? So write a program to read and display n number using array. So you have to, first of all, you have to declare integer I, integer n, and array of 20 integers, and then clear screen, right? Clear screen is a function that you can use to clear everything on the screen. In order to use this clear screen function, you have to include con.io. Stand for console input output dot h, con.io, right? And print out, enter the number of elements. So you can enter the number of elements. For this sample, you enter n is 5, okay? And then, right, printf, get the number to array 0, right? And scan f, right? Percent %id, ampersand, don't forget ampersand, right? And arri, right? You want to read something on screen on and type it by keyboard and then put this number to array, right? One after another. And then after that, you have to print them out, right, from the array, right? You can use this one, right? This is array traversing. Okay, this is very simple. I think this one is very pretty easy for you all. Okay, this one is an example of traversing an array. And sometimes you need to find average or mean of n numbers using array, right? First of all, you have, similarly to the previous program, right? You can just simply get all numbers from keyboard and then put it into array of 5 integers, and then you have to sum it. Right? After you input them, you have to sum it, and then you sum it, and you have to find the mean or the average of these 5 numbers, right? By using float sum divided by n, and then you can get mean, and then print it out. So you can get the mean of the array elements. Okay. So either this one is the operation array traversal. Okay, the next one is a bit complicated, right? When you want to insert an element in an array, what will be happened? Okay, so what shall we do? Suppose we have a data, right? Data array, right? Data array is like this. Okay, even it's this, we declare data 20 elements of integer like this, but you can use only some part of the data, right? Like this. So if you want to insert, insert an array, a value for 75, right, in this array, right? What shall we do? So in this example, right, you can see that the data is sorted in ascending order, right? 12, 23, 34, 45, and so on, right? If you want to insert 75 elements, so you have to compare each of them, right, until you get the right place to and then you will have to put them into this array. How can we do? How can we do is you have to go to the first element, right, to the first element and compare 12 and 75, right? If 12 is still less than 20 or 75, then you have to move on to 23. 23 is still less than to 34, 45, 56, 67, now 78. So you will reach to the place that 75 will be put, right? So you have to substitute 78 to 75, right? But before we will go that, we have to move these 4 elements backward. Oh, actually you have to say forward, right? To forward, right? And then we will place 75. But if we place 75 or substitute 75 to 78 directly, 78 will be disappear. So this is gonna be happened. So what shall we do? So now we have, suppose we have the array like this, right? The result of what we want to do is to insert an element in an array. The result should be like this, right? Right, so can you write a program in order to insert this? Anyone can help me how to solve this problem? Starting from this array, right? And then we want to insert 75 into this array. Mm-hmm. What shall we do? What if we can locate the place that we want to insert, or we want to insert 75 at data 6? Subscript 6, what shall we do? It's my water. One thing is that we have to move these four elements forward, right? Until 78, 89, 90, and 100, they are all in the correct address, correct location. And then 75 will be assigned to the data 6. Am I right? So this is an algorithm, right? The way that you want to implement by using C program, you can do it by yourself, okay? But this is a technique or this idea of how to insert an array, an element to an array. How about the next one? The next one is to insert an array, an element in the middle of an array. Insert to the right position, the position. Okay, you want to insert into this array data, right? Insert what? Insert. What does it mean by this algorithm? This algorithm is to insert A is an array, right? N is a number of elements in the array. Post is the position and value is the value that has to be inserted. From this example, you want to insert 100 into this array, right? So what shall we do? Set I is equal to n. Set I is equal to n. And then I is greater than position, greater than or equal to position, we will have to move, right? AI plus 1 is equal to AI. And set I minus minus. Okay. So in this way, you have to put AI plus 1 is equal to AI. What is I now? I is equal to 6, right? A6 is assigned to A plus 1. Oh, from this algorithm, right, you have just only until data 5, right? And then from the step 3, right, you copy 20 to data 6, okay? And then I minus minus, so you copy 56 to data 5. So you can see that now 20 is moved to here to move forward. 56 move forward as well. And then you copy 12 to data 4, right? So 12 move forward. And then now here we are at the location 5 or the position, no, not 5, 3, at location 3 here. So you can press 100 at the position 3, right? Data, right? 6 element, you want to put 100 at the index subscript 3, right? So here we are. So this is a way to insert an element in the middle of an array. So from the previous example, right, you can also do the same thing, right, to move the last element forward, okay, and then move until you get the right place, right, to insert an element. This is the way that you have to insert an element. The difficulties of why need for step five n is equal to n plus 1. Why? To increase the size of the array. That's right. Because you want to insert one more element. So previously, the number of element is 5, 6. The number of element is 6. So now you have to set up the new length of array. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lamin. Okay. Any problem? Any questions? So you can do the same thing like this for the previous example, but the length of the new array is not used in the function at all. Yes, this is just the first time use. Okay. For array, right? I've just told you that for this array, right, even you declare, okay, you can declare data for 20 elements of integer, right? But you can use for some locations. So you need to keep track on the length of the array, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? For this example, it's 10 out of 20. So you need to keep track on the number of the elements in this data, okay? That's why n has to be changed by yourself. You have to keep track on n. This is the number of elements by yourself. Because you don't use every element in array. Hey, thank you for your question. And what's happened if you want to delete an element from an array? The easiest one is to remove the last element of the array, right? So you can set upper bound to be upper bound minus 1 and then exit. This is the easiest way or easiest method when you want to delete the last element of an array. But what's happened if you want to delete an element inside array? It's not necessary to be the last one, right? How can we do? Suppose we have an array like this, and then we want to delete 56 from this array, right? What can we do? So the result will be like this, right? 56 will be removed. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty easy. I'm not sure whether you are. You can follow from this. You can follow the step like this, right? Delete. Okay, this is you have to delete an element from an array, right? You have to redefine the subscript. Okay. For this example, what you have to do is, if you want to delete 56, right? You can just simply copy 67 to the place of 56 and copy 78 to here until you go to the last element that is n, right? And then it will be copied to the place of 90. And then you have to reduce the number of elements n by 1, right? N is equal to n minus 1. So that's all. This is the way that we will delete. It's pretty easy. Delete an element from an array. But what if we want to delete an array at a particular position, right? Delete in array A, right? And we have n elements here. And then we want to delete this position, what can we do, right? Set I is equal to position. So we step go to the position. Okay. So what shall we do in this example? What we are going to remove? We are going to remove 34. Okay. We want to remove 34, right? So we said I is equal to position. What does it mean? What is the position for 34? 2, right? I is 2. So 2 is still less than n minus 1, right? So AI, A2 is equal to AI plus 1. AI plus 1 is AT. So you have to assign 12 to the place of 34, right? So 12 will be here. And then I plus, then 56 will be assigned to here. And then I plus, I plus 1, 20 will be moved to 20, to data 4, right? And then now, I is 5, and 5 is the number. 5 less than or equal to 5, 6 minus 1. 6 minus 1 is 5. Now, 12, 56, and 20 are copies to the correct location. And then you have to set n is equal to n minus 1. And you decrease the number of n by 1. So that's all for this. This is an algorithm to delete an element from array. Maybe you can check for the I or the subscription, right? When you are trying to convert from this this model or this algorithm to C programming, okay? Okay, this is a piece of code that how to write a program to delete a number from a given location in an array, right? So first of all, you have to assign array, the element in an array, and then you need to enter the position to be deleted, right? In this example, suppose we want to delete number 3, right? So the location number 3 will be deleted. Right, so we can have 1, 2, 3, and number 3 will be deleted, so 4 will be deleted. So you can have the new number array subscript 3 is 5, right? According to this one, this program. I suggest you that after this class, right, I will okay, it's not compulsory, but I suggest you to try to write this program, right, in order to practice how to write C program, right, for deleting an element from the from array, right? So you can understand more into detail about how to deal with the array. Okay. I know that the piece of course are provided in the PDF file, right? So, but I still suggest you to write by yourself, right? Write the program by yourself. So it, because it will guarantee that you understand this one, this concept clearly, okay? And the next concept that you may have to know that is, suppose you have two arrays and then you want to merge them together into one array. So what shall we do? Merging two arrays in a third array means first copying the contents to the first array into the third array, and then copying the contents of the second array into the third array, right? It is okay if the two arrays are not sorted. Right, if the arrays are unsorted, merging array is very simple. You can just simply copy the content to another. That's all. but it is not easy if two arrays are sorted. If two arrays are sorted, so you have to merge them, and the result, the resulting array need to be sorted as well. So what shall we do? This one is a way that we want to merge two array, two unsorted array, right? Array one and array two. So you can simply copy the first array to the third array, and then copy array two to the third array as well, right? But you have to continue from the current position. For this example, array one will be end up. Okay, array three will be end up at 69, right? And then the next. The first array of the first element of array two will start from the current position at array three. So you have to keep tab on the location or the subscript of the array three carefully. Okay. Okay. I think that's all for the for reviewing about the array and how to use array. Okay, so up to now, do you have any questions about array? For homework, could you please try to write programs to merge two sorted array? If you have two sorted arrays, right, and then you are trying to merge them together into array tree, how can we do? Okay, you can use the concept of deleting and inserting arrays before, right? And write a program. This is a homework. Okay. Okay, now it is 3:25. I took 5 minutes late. Okay. Do you have any questions?